Dr. JP Singh, I'm afraid I can't hear you at the moment. If you can just check, it may be a technical issue. We'll have to just check it. Yeah. I can't hear you, Dr. JP Singh.
Can you hear me now?
It's better now, sir. A little louder, please. Okay. It's better now. Thank you.
Okay. Actually, like this year, we have faced, after 20 years, the unprecedented situation due to this locust incursion. There was a very serious attack last year in the month of May onwards, and which remain continue till February of this year. Mm-hmm. And we have undertaken control measures in almost 8 to 9 districts of Rajasthan, 2 districts of Gujarat, and 1 district of Punjab in 4,04,000 hectare of area. And that time it was coincided with the monsoon. This year we have experienced very early incursion or attack of locusts from our neighboring countries, Pakistan. And this has started first in the form of hoppers and subsequently in the form of immature adults, which we are experiencing now. Several of swarms have entered from Sri Ganganagar district, the Fazilka of Punjab, Badmer, Jaisalmer, Bikaner area. And these swarms are of the size of 1 square kilometer to 10 square kilometers. So they are very fast moving, and since there is very less vegetation during this summer after harvest of rabi crops, so these are fast moving immature adults move to, with the help of heavy winds, they move to they reach to the distant areas. Though we have a large number of teams, 47 Central Ministry of Agriculture locust warning organized teams are working in close coordination of the state governments of Rajasthan, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh, UP, Gujarat, and with the help of farmers and state governments, we are mobilizing all these resources, whether it's a ground vehicle mounted sprayers, or it's a tractor mounted sprayers, or the farmer support. All these resources are being mobilized to the sites, and under these control measures are being undertaken overnight, because by the evening these swarms get settled into the area. Sometimes they get settled on the high trees, sometime in the desert area, sometime in the acacia plantation, sometime in very high altitude sand dunes. So our survey teams try to locate as quick as possible with the help of, you see, we have deployed from Central Ministry of Agriculture more than 200 personnel to these areas. And we are getting sufficient support from the respective state governments and district administrations to locate these swarms and undertake timely control measures. So as far as this damage is concerned, we don't have the exact information, because the damage actually comes later on. Though there's a very limited coverage as far as the crops are concerned, because most of the rabi crops already been harvested. Right. Some crops are there, so the damage, I think there's a very minimum damage chances are there, but still we are in the process of ascertaining these facts from the respective state governments.
And Dr. Singh, in a time like this, you mentioned that it's good that the rabi crop harvesting has been done, and therefore the crop damage is limited.
तो हमारे फोर्स ने वार्निंग फायर करने के बावजूद मिल्टन गाड़ी घुमा के वहाँ से भागा. अगला नाका पार्टी भी उस पर वार्निंग फायरिंग किया तो उस जगह मिल्टन, चूँकि अंधेरा था, गाड़ी को छोड़ के वहाँ से भाग गया. हमारी पार्टी दूर से लाइट से देखा तो कुछ सस्पिशियस लगा, और जब गाड़ी का सेम नंबर मिला जिसको एक्सपेक्टेड कर रहे थे हम लोग, तो कॉर्डन को टाइट कर दिया और फर्स्ट लाइट का वेट करा. और आज मॉर्निंग में अपना बी डी एस्क्वाड गया, जब उसने देखा कि इसमें आईडी एक्सप्लोसिव लोडेड व्हीकल है, तो हमारी टीम वहां जाके उसमें आर्मी सीआरपी पुलिस की टीम जाके उस
अंडमान सागर और अंडमान निकोबार द्वीप समूह के शेष हिस्सों में आगे बढ़ा है. मौसम विज्ञानियों का कहना है कि दक्षिण पश्चिम मॉनसून और आगे बढ़ता जाएगा, क्योंकि अगले 48 घंटों के दौरान मालदीव कोमोरिन क्षेत्र के कुछ और हिस्सों में इसके लिए परिस्थितियां अनुकूल हो रही हैं. दक्षिण पूर्व और उससे सटे पूर्वी मध्य अरब सागर के ऊपर 31 मई से 4 जून के दौरान एक कम दबाव का क्षेत्र बनने की संभावना है। ये स्थितियां दिखाती हैं कि केरल में दक्षिण पश्चिम मानसून की शुरुआत के लिए 1 जून से परिस्थितियां बेहद अनुकूल होंगी। भारतीय मौसम विभाग ने यह भी घोषणा की है कि केरल में 1 जून से दक्षिण पश्चिम मानसून की शुरुआत के लिए परिस्थितियां अनुकूल हैं।